2 weeks from now. All prepared? What is preparation for marriage? Besides the clothes and the jewelry and the tent and the food and the invitations, huh?
I think it's mental preparation more than anything else.
Absolutely. Ordinarily, we jump into a marriage, hai na? And that's what we say, phir padhai ho gayi hai, job bhi lag gaya hai, ya business mein lag gaye hain, to ab shaadi kar lete hain. But is that reason enough to get married? So let's look at some more legitimate reasons to get married. Amber?
Need of companionship.
Exactly. Progeny? Of course. Financial support, companionship. She look after my parents, he look after my parents, etc. Lots of other reasons that we always find for getting married, right? Do you think there could be something else, some other reasons to get married? Or what do all these reasons point towards? What are they all leading us towards? Companionship is leading to happiness. Togetherness is leading to happiness. Or because we want to be happy, we'll have children. So all of these reasons are leading to happiness. So we are getting married so that we are happy. Now, when we look at marriages, do we always find everybody really happy, happy, happy? No. Sometimes, mostly, but not always. Because we really haven't thought about the different aspects of happiness in marriage, right? We say marriage is a unification of two people. But unification should be looked at with a little bit of a microscope, magnifying glass, and see what is the unification we are talking about. Right? Kanika, is that right? So actually, we see ourselves as Kanika, we see ourselves as Amber. But am I just Kanika, or do I have different levels of consciousness of my being? Right? I'm a physical being. So let us go through this marriage, this unification of two people, and see how can we make this unification at different levels of our being more and more realistic, more and more beautiful, more and more real, more and more true, so that we achieve happiness. सबसे पहले हम क्या हैं? We are a physical being. So let us talk of unification at the physical level. Right? At the physical level, you're going to live in a material world. And a material world involves joys and sorrows. They involve successes and they involve failures. And being united together means dealing with these joys and happiness, success and failure absolutely as one. If we have two views, we sit down, we discuss them together, till we come to one view, and then we deal with the problem. Right? This ordinarily we all know. Now, at the physical level, we also understand that it's a unification of two bodies. So there is also in it the sexual relationship, which need not be shunned. Generally, people will say, "Arey, hum to spiritual level pe hain, to hum." No. Our rishis never shunned the sexual relationship in a marriage. Why? Because they were realistic. This is the human anatomy, it needs it. So do not try to shun away from it, but utilize it in the right manner. Right? Whenever we say, do anything in the right manner, what we have learned from Sri Aurobindo and what we have learned from the Gita, doing it in the right manner is offering it to Krishna, offering whatever you are doing. Whatever you are doing. एक बार आपका जो भी ईश माने भगवान हैं आपके लिए कृष्ण हो जीसस हो ऑफ कोर्स वी आर ऑल हियर हिंदूज प्राइमरीली बट इट डजंट मैटर इट कुड बी कृष्णा इट कुड बी हनुमान इट कुड बी हुएवर यू वांट बट टू ऑफर इट टू दैट डिविनिटी विद इन टू दैट डिविनिटी ऑल अराउंड वॉट एवर यू आर डूइंग एंड देन डूइंग इट फॉर हिम इट जस्ट इंस्टेंटली ओपन्स योर चैनल्स टू गॉड opens your channels to the higher. I generally tell my students this. You're sitting in an examination. Now you're tense. But if just for 1 second before opening the question paper or before the question paper is distributed to you, connect to the divine within and offer the entire writing of the answers to him. Can you imagine what it does? What does it do, Ambar?
Basically,
it calms you down. What else? That's one of the very small advantages of offering. The larger advantage.
Gives you the strength to sort of deal with it.
Who gives you the strength?
The fact that we've opened ourselves to the good or the bad, whatever comes our way.
No, we haven't opened ourselves to the bad because we have connected to Krishna, Hanuman, whoever it is. When we've connected ourselves to God and we've offered it to God, what is happening?
You've surrendered
and you've also opened the channels of communication. So, what I generally tell my students is ki aap khud answer likhoge ya aapka divine likhega, kuch to bahut bada farak hoga usme. Why not open the channels? Hum jo bhi kar rahe hain, kitni der lagti hai? It takes hardly 2 seconds. Hey Krishna, yahan in logon ne bola hai marriage pe bolne, maine to aaj tak kabhi marriage pe kuch bola nahi hai. I offer it to you. What happens? I open the lines of communication and I allow him to speak through me. Otherwise, it's my ego. When I'm writing my paper, it's me writing from my mental level, which is very limited. And I've opened myself, it's another thing. Anyway, we've gone off. So we were talking about the physical level, so we should not shun the sexual part of it. Why? There are 4 purposes of the Hindu marriage. 4 purposes. The first purpose is progeny or praja, right? The second purpose is sexual pleasure or rati. The third is happiness or ananda. And the fourth, most important purpose of the Hindu marriage is to be able to attain dharma together. Right? Dharma santati or sahatvam. So these are the 4 purposes of a Hindu marriage. Now we've, this union at the physical or the mental level would really help to gain a happy marriage. But this is not enough. Because this is not the only level that we are at. Hum khali physical being to nahi hai na? So what else are we? Which other level should we unite? We should unite at the sensational level. We are also sensational beings. Right? What does a sensational being say? What? Give me some example of sensation. Aesthetic tastes, for instance, our enjoyments, our pleasures, these are all our senses, you know, the sensational being. Now we have to unite ourselves at the sensational level as well. For instance, he may enjoy rock music, but Kanika may not enjoy it at all. And Kanika may enjoy classical music, but Ambar says, oh my goodness me, classical music mein baithna padega, Pandit Hari Prasad Chaurasia bajayenge, mujhe sunna padega. Sunna padega, Ambar. क्योंकि कनिका एंजॉय करती है इसलिए मैं भी संग में बैठूंगा आई विल डिवेलप दैट पार्ट ऑफ माय एस्थेटिक सेंस व्हिच कनिका हैज व्हिच आई डोंट हैव एंड कनिका विल सिट थ्रू द रॉक कॉन्सर्ट व्हाई बिकॉज अंबर एंजॉयज इट सो इफ आई हैवंट डिवेलप्ड इट आई विल डिवेलप इट दिस इज यूनिफिकेशन एट द सेंसेशनल लेवल राइट ही एंजॉयज अ At a later level in life, don't develop it, but just be there because you love him.
Beyond the point, it's hard to.
Beyond the point, it may be hard, but they are just starting.
We are talking from experience.
They're starting off, and maybe they're able to manage to start enjoying each other's aesthetic pleasures. So let's give them an opportunity, and then we always are able to find that middle path. But maybe. Yeah, he may enjoy the violence of a James Bond movie and she may enjoy the pathos of a art movie. And why not? I mean, if I love her, I can sit through that pathos and she can sit through that sensation of the James Bond movie. Why not?
If you haven't started, it's all about possibilities for them.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. But give them the possibility. And let them research. Let them just go through the entire thing. So to be able to share each other's passions and pleasures, to be moved by the same common things, are necessary for a good marriage. But this is not enough. So which is the next level? The next level is our emotional level. We have different emotional levels, you know. But we have decided that together we are going to bond with a lot of mutuality, a lot of love, a lot of affection for each other. And that is the commitment that you get to the table when you're getting married. That commitment to love each other, be whatever may happen, that commitment on the table must never be forgotten. I'm sure that there'll be times when you'll feel like, man, what have I done? There may be times when you're going to throw the plate at each other. There are going to be a lot of plate throwing, and there are going to be tantrums. And Amber, men are as good at tantrums as girls are. So there'll be lots of it. There'll be lots of shouting, public and private. There will be, loud and quiet. And sometimes it gets so quiet that it gets kind of cold, you know, chilly. But remember, at the emotional level, I have united. And what does that emotional level unification mean? We just talked about it.
Being one.
Committed to love her irrespective. Commitment that I love her. She's acting strange. It's okay. But I made a commitment. I love her despite. And the same.